That's me and Galapa, the first sailboat there in the bay. Been there several weeks, but now I don't have the luxury of filling my water tanks from the dock. That's alright, it's good exercise. Plus, we can't really go anywhere, at least not to the places I want to go. Many borders are still closed, as well as other Cape Verde islands. Again, that's fine with me. Mindelo is more or less open again. Our talented musical friend Jody is also stuck and making do just fine. As well, Galapa needs fixing up. Look at my lazy bag. The wind has just ripped it open and the dust still accumulates. These guys showed up, apparently from Brazil. Their anchor had broken and were directed by the marina to moor at a mooring ball. While the authorities were checking them in, the mooring broke and they started drifting towards Simon's boat, the big white catch there. They had not noticed, and with luck I happened to see it happen, whistled and screamed to turn their engine on. And they managed to steer clear. Finally, they were able to dock at Marina Mindelo. They'd have to wait out their quarantine time there. And me, well, I had a post-surgery checkup. The clinic being next to the police, I went to pick up my passport with a prolonged visa. I can stay here until September 28th. Our friend Peter is about to sail to Canada, but he's got to take care of an important thing before going. It's Lily's birthday, and since there is a romantic story developing here, Peter spared no expense. Of course, our core group of friends were here. Our family, as Lily calls it, Mauricio, Fanny, Sushi, and Ayrton, Peter's son. Then several more friends of hers came. There's Sulesia, Carly, Ashley, Tracy, Brun, and Mara. Like everywhere else in the world, everyone is on their phone sharing the event with friends and family. It looks like there will be another love story between a sailor and a Mindelese. This has been the story of Mindelo since its time began. The boat is being cleaned and prepped from top to bottom. Tomorrow is the day they sail off to Canada. Are Peter and Ayrton ready?
Is that a good spot?
Yep, you're good. Okay.
Our bilge pumps are actually pretty amazing. They're multifunctional. They got lots of different ports and switches, and we got two of them and spare parts, and they missed a spot. they missed one compartment, and when it fills up with water, it's very splashy, and it sucks. So we're fixing that right now.
I mean, the radio's done, autopilot's good, all of our instruments seem fine.
Everything's fine, yeah.
Generator is still crap.
The generators are unreliable at best.
Peter and Ayrton are leaving tomorrow to go to sail to Canada. It's kind of hard to believe when you look at the condition of the boat right now.
Fuck off! Jesus Christ. Hey! He likes a judgy Swiss guy.
So let's hope they get off to fair wind start tomorrow.
Oh yeah.
What are those, diapers?
Yeah, they came with the boat. I think it was for oil spills.
Now the plan is that Pete's going to go all the way back to Canada, back to British Columbia. And then, because he's smitten with Lily and vice versa, he's supposed to come back in 2-3 months. And I'm supposed to wait. I don't know if I don't know. I'm debating what I'm going to do, so.
We didn't say wait. We said, just know where you are.
Where will I be? That is the question. But first, where will I go? My options are, 1, go to Europe. No way, I'm not going back north. 2, go to Senegal, haul out the boat and take care of Galapin's underbelly. But borders are closed. I may have to wait in a reputed dirty bay for weeks. 3, stay here, take care of Galapin as best as I can and wait until Cape Verde opens up so I can discover the last 3 islands I'm missing. I'd take Lily and a friend and we'd sail around Cape Verde until Peter comes back, which he plans to. And then we'd go to Senegal together. This cat came from somewhere, fueled up and stocked up on food, and left a few days later. Peter did not go back like he planned. He could not get his generator working, so he bought a new one that he wants to put on deck. He realized he'll need to make some kind of housing for it to protect it from the spray and water. So we went to see a carpenter, who happens to be Lily's dad. There, way above the city in Bella Vista, is where they live and he has a shop. This is Piduca. We bought a plank of marine-grade wood and some screws. He juggled his schedule to make a sturdy box for tomorrow, because Peter's going. Peruca is a master carpenter. He showed us some of the works he'd done. He's quite a skilled craftsman. The next day, he'd done the job. He charged about $15. Peter gave him a $20 bill, and off we were. Peter can finally set off to Canada. Or not. Turns out Peter doesn't have to go so soon. Because of COVID-19, one of the planned events he was supposed to attend has been postponed. So what do we do? Well, how about having a barbecue on one of our favorite beaches with our favorite friends? Girls went to check out the surf while we stoked up the coals. Fanny took the hold of being grillmeister.
What did you mean?
My doctor told me I should go for a swim in the ocean. It would be good for my wounds. So after a couple of delectable grilled pork chops, the beach was ours. I mean, just for us. We're the only ones here. This island of volcanic rocks sprouting out of the Atlantic, dry as a desert, is a paradise. It is home to some of the most beautiful and resilient people anywhere, and it's become our home. We're all stuck here in a COVID-free paradise. But even in paradise, accidents happen. Peter took a dive into a wave and met up with another type of prominent resident, a rock. Lily berated me for filming Peter and went to be by his side. We followed, of course. And Peter?
Hey, how's it going?
He has a nice gouge on his nose and lip. And we still had some chicken to chow. Peter's a tough man of the North. He's not gonna let a scratch mess up his adventures here.
Boy, this is some fucking geography that we don't normally have. Really?
Life goes on in Mindelo, for all of us.